After that, this result is on similar line that we already discussed in lecture number 1, that is in term of sequence xn. But here the result is in term of operator, and next it will be in term of functional. After that, it will be in term of Hilbert space. So all the three results are different, but on same line of actions. Now the statement of this theorem is: a sequence Tn which belongs to B and N dash. It means it is a sequence of bounded linear transformation, where N and N dash are Banach space, and this is a strongly convergent operator. If it is a strongly convergent operator, if and only if it satisfies two conditions, A and B part. A part, the sequence norm of Tn is bounded. B part, the sequence Tn x is a Cauchy in N dash. For every x belongs to M. What is M? M is a total set in N. So first, what is total set? Total set mean, if M is total in N, then M span of M is dense in N. Span of M is dense in M means closure of span of M is equal to capital N. Now, proof of this result. So first part, let Tn is strongly convergent to T. If it is strongly convergent to T, then it implies Tnx approaches to Tx for every x belongs to N. This is by definition. Now, this sequence is convergent. Every convergent sequence is bounded. So it implies Tnx is a bounded set. So this is a bounded sequence by uniform bounded principle. So again, you can see this result by uniform bounded principle. That is, again, the four results are very important: Hahn-Banach, closed graph, open mapping, and uniform bounded principle. So see the detail of uniform bounded principle. By uniform bounded principle, if Tnx is bounded, then the sequence norm of Tn is a bounded. So it implies A part is proved. So this is just by using uniform bounded principle, we prove the A part. Again, B part. So again, by definition, Tnx approaches to Tx, it implies this. Now, to prove the Cauchy sequence, Tnx minus Tmx, this can be written as Tnx minus Tx plus Tx minus Tmx by using triangle inequality. Now, this term by using this result approaches to zero. This term approaches to zero as Mn approaches to infinity. It means Tnx minus Tmx approaches to zero as Mn approaches to infinity. So it means this is a Cauchy sequence in N dash. So this is Cauchy sequence in N dash. The sequence Tnx is a Cauchy sequence for all x belongs to M. Why? That is very simple. Because if it is a Cauchy sequence in N and M is a part of N, so it means this condition is also applicable for its subset. So the sequence Tnx is a Cauchy sequence for all x belongs to M, where M is total set in N. Clear? So it means, which proves the part B. Now, A and B part is given, or we want to prove that the basic result ki Tn is strongly convergent to T. Now A part gave ki this sequence is bounded. So that is written in equation number 2. Simple. Second, by B part, M is total set in N by definition. Span of M, the closure equal to N. So that is written in 3 part. 3, equation number 3. Let epsilon greater than 0 be an arbitrary number. For every X belongs to N, by equation number 3, N is equal to span of M, the closure. It implies get this here we take y no right for every x belongs to n is equal to span of m the closure, then by definition if we there exist some y belongs to span of m, there exist some y belongs to span of m such that norm of x minus y less than epsilon by 3c. Clear? So this is less than some positive number that depends upon our requirement. So we know that our requirement is epsilon by 3c, otherwise we can fill it later on. Now this is in equation number 4. Since y belongs to span of M and Tny is a Cauchy sequence by B, right? Then there exists a positive integer N naught, norm of Tny minus Tmy less than epsilon by 3 for every Mn greater than equal to nj. So this is a definition of a Cauchy sequence. Let mn greater than equal to n0 and x belongs to capital N. So norm of tnx minus tmx can be written in this form: tnx minus tny plus tny minus tmy plus tmy minus tmx. Now using triangle inequality, if we use triangle inequality, so this is less than equal to first term, second term and third term. By using bounded operator, norm of this is less than equal to norm of tn into norm of x minus y. So here these are two different terms. So this term is written in the same form. Here again using the less than equal to norm of Tm, norm of y minus x. So first and third term are basically same. The difference is here we are using n, here we are using m. So for first and third term, we use this is less than equal to norm of C. Again, this is less than equal to norm of C. And this term is less than equal to epsilon by 3C. This term is less than epsilon by 3. So basically, we use equation number 4 and equation number 2 for first and third. We use equation number 2 and equation number 4. So what we get? We get this is C into epsilon by 3C and C into epsilon by 3C. For second term, we use this term Tny minus Tmy less than epsilon by 3. It is possible if M and Na greater than equal to n0. So by using this term, this is again less than epsilon by 3. So total term is less than epsilon. So this is possible for every mn greater than or equal to n0. It means Tnx is a Cauchy sequence in n dash. Remember this. It is a Cauchy sequence in n dash. N dash is complete. The given part n dash is complete. It means every Cauchy sequence is convergent. So Tnx converge in n dash. Then it implies the sequence Tn is strongly convergent in n dash. That prove the result. That is a, this is very important result.